Watches, 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 everywhere watches. Would you like to have some control over your collection? So there are actually two possibilities. First one is to buy a watch collector logbook or record book like this, and you can track there and write all information about your watch. And you can buy this on Amazon KDP store, and I have prepared one also for you. You can buy it from my store. Check the outer ticking watch, it's me. Okay, but I mentioned also about a second possibility, and the second possibility is to use a Microsoft Excel. In the next minutes, I will show you how to make a record book or some collector tracking file. So let's start. In the first row, I will write the most important categories. Please remember that all what you see here is only an example, and it should give you some knowledge that you can make one for yourself that suits you. And I'm sure that some things can be done even better than I'm doing this, so if you have some ideas, put a comment in the comment section down below. Okay, so some categories we already have, now dimensions, so what we need is diameter, thickness. So band material, now movement, and by movement we have type, caliber of course, maybe number of jewels and some other informations. Of course style is very important, features, or also we can call it watch complications, service or repair, any other useful information, maybe a seal date and seal price also will be needed. So now I will make a quick formatting. I will wrap and merge some cells together. Okay, let's adjust everything, and now maybe I will add these two rows. Okay, let's make also formatting here, so maybe some color, and this one will be okay. And let's enter here our title of our collection. So my collection, pretty simple, you can write here what you want. Let's also format this in the similar way. Okay, let's make also the border a little bit thicker, and let's bold all these titles here of the all categories. Okay, and also I would like to freeze here the first four rows and the first columns, and here we have it. Okay, so here maybe I would like to have a sum or subtotal. Let's write here how much my collection is worth, so I would like to know how much I spent all over the years my watches. And let's enter the first watch here, some example, it's Longines Avignon Big Eye, or you spell this somehow in this way. So all this data are just made up. Let's make here currency dollar, so let's be a little bit more traditional. Now dimensions, this I took from the Longines internet page. Okay, another thing, I would like to have also a possibility to filter depending on what I would like to know about my collection, and I will use for that the row number 5 and put here a filter so that I can in the future when I will have much more watches to filter them, for example, which watches I bought in 2021, for example, yeah? Let's make it this color a little bit different, so just that I know that this is the filter here. And let's insert now a second sheet, and this sheet will be a support data, because I would like to write here all features that repeat. So for example, case material, stainless steel repeats by many watches. Leather strap also repeats, so I would like to make from this all features a drop down list, and exactly for that I need this support data. Well, I see here that I forgot about one very important feature. It is a water resistance. Okay, some spelling mistake. Okay, let's start. So movement type, style of the watch. This is also I would like to have on my drop-down list. Features, a watch complication, and of course water resistance. It is that what I forgot. Quick formatting. Give me a few seconds. And yeah, well, maybe let's start this fill in because I need it. So features, so chronograph or watch complications, day date indicator, what else can be here, power reserve for example. Now movement type can be mechanical automatic watch, can be mechanical manual, can be a quartz movement, can be a mecha quartz movement, can be a quartz kinetic. So smartwatch, maybe let's write here electronic movement. What else we can have, for example a pendulum clock, water resistance. By old watches we have no information. Let's write this as a pressure, this water resistance. Now the band material can be missing. Style, dress, formal, dive, military, case material, stainless steel, the same is the band material, also can be stainless steel. So okay, so I fill in it quickly. Let's sort this maybe in alphabetical order, all these features. And the air water resistance all the we have in order. Okay, so now I have this support list. I here see here is a duplicate. Let's delete this one additional power reserve. Okay, and having now all these data, I can use them in my drop down list. Now I will make a drop down list. So how is it done? First you go to the data tab and then you choose a data validation button. Now I choose list, and the third step is very important. In the source I choose my list of case materials, and here we have it. That's our drop down list, and I can just choose the one to write case material. But this list has one drawback. For example, I would like to add here a new material, for example yellow gold plated, and if I go back to my drop down list it doesn't appear there. So what I have to do next is to repeat all steps, make again everything what I have done before, and now I have this yellow gold plated material. But to avoid that, I can make my drop down list a little bit more dynamic, and I can use an Excel offset function. So offset, then I choose the first cell of my case material, then 3 times semicolon. By some versions of Excel it can be comma. Then the next step is to choose another Excel function, is count a bracket, and next step is to choose the range of my case material, so it will be between A2 and A50 because I don't think I will have more options than 49. Of course you can choose different range. Okay, let's check how is it working. So let's remove this gold plated and it disappeared. Let's remove another one, it's also disappeared, is a free space. Let's remove this, make it in alphabetical order, and yeah, it works. And let's maybe add again this yellow gold plated. Okay, now let's move to the band material. So we need to repeat the whole process. We write offset function, choose the right range, count A, of course before brackets, and the range, and okay, we have it. We can also improve a little bit our drop down list by adding input message, for example select one option or something similar. Now I will do what is not needed to have be done. I will limit my list to the row 200. Let's make some formatting. This will be okay, maybe some numbers here, and now I can go on with my list. Let's check if is it working. Okay, I see here also a spelling mistake. Let's check if there appear this artificial letter. Yeah, it's there. Okay, but let's move on with our Longines. So it's stainless steel case, leather band. The movement type is again a drop down list. So let's make it a drop down list. Offset function, electronic. So C2 and up to 50. And to have the same, I can just copy the cells to the row 200. Okay, mechanical automatic, caliber type L688, 27 joules and other, so I know this movement is based on ETA A08L01. Quick formatting, now the style, again drop down list, offset function, support data, count A. Okay, so we have the style in column Q. Let's maybe number all the columns because I will need it in a moment. And using Ctrl Shift and arrow down key combination, I will copy my drop down list to the all cells down below. And let's insert also the input message here. Okay, so my watch is a pilot or aviator. That's the star. And now the features. So again, I repeat the whole process with my offset function. Some mistake. And two brackets on the end. And now I would like to choose the right. Oh, well, I see I have here a duplicate. Let's remove it. Okay, what I'm facing here now is that my watch has more features than one, but I can select only one option. So what I have to do now is to go to developer tab and write a code in Visual Basic. And if you don't see this tab, you just go to option and make it visible like this. You need only select developer. Okay, so let's choose the Visual Basic button. And in our sheet 1, my watches, we have to write a VBA code. Similar codes like this can be found in internet. Let's make copy and paste and of course save it. Here only Excel informs us that this Excel file will have also a macro inside. Okay, so let's check if is it working. Yep, we can choose more options. So let's save our file as a macro, so as XLSM. You need to do that because other way you will lose your macro. Another thing, pay attention on this line. In VBA for columns, instead of letters, we write numbers. And in our case, we can make multi-selection only in column 18 and 12. Because like here, band can be made from leather and nylon, or like in this swatch that you saw before, from ceramic and stainless steel. Okay, features of our Longines, of our example, are here. Now the water resistance. And for the water resistance, we have to make the drop down list. Here is simple because we have only one option here. Okay, our function. Now I'm copying only the function to other cells, and we cannot forget about input message. Okay, quick formatting, and our water resistance 10 atmospheres. And let's also allow multi-selection in case material. And to do that, the only thing that we need to do is in this line, just copy and paste and change the number 12 to 11. Why I'm doing this? Because also the case can be made, for example, from brass and can be chromium plated. So it can have different materials. Last thing is a subtotal here. So I would like to have a possibility to know how much I spent for watches in a given year. For that I'm using subtotal function number 9 for sum and cells between 6 and 199. Okay, let's quickly check is it working, some amounts and dates. This last two we change on 2017. Okay, this last one I don't need. Okay, let's check 2016. Okay, the sum is from 2016, 2017, the sum is from 2017, and now all. Okay, so last formatting left. I think everyone can do this on your own. Here by additional notes you can write what you want, for example, where you bought your watch. Now please let me allow to do two last things. The first one, let's put here for the case material an input message, multi-selection is possible. Apply for all and okay. Okay, here we have it. And the second thing, you remember that on my support data, I have chosen a range between row 2 and 50. So therefore, let's just mark this and let's make some nice formatting so that in the future we know that here ends our list of options. And after this range, it isn't dynamic, it won't work automatically. Okay, so if you like this video, hit the like button and share with someone who you think also would be interested in this kind of watch collector in Excel. And if you don't want to do your own, you can just buy from my Amazon KDP. So just choose ticking watch. I have also there a different watch collector's logbooks. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you learn something new. If you have some question or ideas, feel free and use the comment section down below. See also my other videos. Thanks for watching. Take care. Stay healthy. Bye bye.